everyone and welcome back to my channel. I hope you guys are doing good today. So in today's video, I am going to talk about if I had to keep only 10 makeup products. So you guys know I do have quite some, you know, collection of makeup. I have good amount of foundations, concealers, bronzers, blushes. But if I had to keep only 10 makeup products and throw away the rest, these are the 10 makeup products I would choose. Now, this list would definitely change over time because over time I fall in love with different products. But currently, if I had to just pick 10 from my makeup collection, these are the ones that I would pick. So without further ado, let's get started on with the video. Also, if you are someone who's new to this channel, thank you so much for watching. I post affordable makeup, affordable skincare on this channel. And if you think that this is your vibe, you can click the subscribe button and also the notification bell, because that way you are going to stay updated every time I post a new video. So without further ado, let's get started. So the first product is a primer. Now, I do have quite an extensive collection of primers. But I just thought if I had to keep one, I would keep something that is very unique formulation wise and that I know that I will actually enjoy. So a lot of the primers that I have are very hydrating. Now I can do the hydrating part with a moisturizer too, but I chose this primer. This is the CAL primer and this is the Insta Beam Illuminating Oil, facial oil. Yeah, primer oil. So I love this because I don't know why. This actually makes my foundation look so good. It doesn't matter what foundation I'm using. I can use one of the like the cakiest foundation. This is still going to make it look good on my skin and that is why I like it. Now this is an oil type of a primer. I know that this is not going to suit maybe oily skin, but this is not something that doesn't get soaked up. It doesn't feel oily. That's why I like it. And I did not use this in today's video because I know a lot of people don't like when I use a lot of highlighting or, you know, products, because I do have lights in my room and it just reflects a lot of light. So that is why I did not use it in today's video. But in real, this actually is amazing. It has micro shimmers in it, very, very tiny. You cannot even see that when you apply it on your face. This has squalene in it. So what happens is squalene is a very lightweight oil, so it just gets absorbed very easily. And honestly, I do have to say this doesn't feel like an oil at all. The formulation is quite unique, so that is why I definitely am going to be keeping this. So the next product I have here is a foundation. So this is the PAC Spotlight Foundation. Now, I don't know why people don't talk about this foundation enough. I have to say I do have quite a bit of foundation, you guys know that, but I chose something that is not way too hydrating but not way too, you know, matte as well. This is the perfect formulated foundation, I feel like. And not only that, it has good coverage and it's also just, it looks very, very flawless. That's what I have to say. I have been using this foundation almost for a year now, and if I had to choose one foundation from my collection, I would still go to this. This is how much I actually love this foundation. And when I know that I have to look good and I just have to look flawless, either be it on pictures and in real, I always choose this foundation because I know no matter what my skin condition is, this foundation always, always looks good. And I just have to say that this has the perfect, perfect amount of coverage to it, and you can build it up to high coverage also. But I do really like this foundation a lot more than their HD foundation. I would say the HD foundation is a little bit more full coverage, a little bit more matte on the skin, but this one has the most natural type of a foundation, you know, a vibe to it, but yet it does give me coverage. So I chose this because if I use a little less of this foundation, I can put this like a BB cream, and if I use a little bit more, I can use this like a foundation. So it's like a very versatile kind of a product. So as for my concealer, I did choose this Studio West concealer. Now I have a reason why I chose this, because this just looks like I have not applied any concealer. This obviously does not give me a lot of coverage. It's not meant to give you a lot of coverage, but I do like it. It just covers up a little bit of my under eye darkness and it just looks so good, especially because I do have dry under eyes. And this is a very, it leans more towards on the hydrating side. So I don't like to set my concealers at all. So I just noticed that this looks good. This doesn't settle into my fine lines a lot. It doesn't crease that much. Obviously, this is a concealer. It is going to crease, but it's not, it doesn't crease that much. It doesn't feel like I'm putting on a concealer. So that is why I like this. But definitely I do have to say this is not a full BAM, you know, like a high coverage concealer. So if you're someone you don't like high coverage, you are going to love this concealer, and this has been my newer favorite concealer. So as for powder, I am someone I don't use powder that much, although I did powder my face today because it's very hot and humid and sometimes I do have to powder my face. So I chose the Maybelline Fit Me powder. This is the compact powder, and I don't like to use a loose powder because obviously, as I said, I have dry skin and I just don't like my face to look powdery and matte. So I use this. This just gives this just sets the makeup really well, and it's a very decent type of a powder, you know, everybody talks about it and I honestly love it a lot. So now for bronzer, I chose the Nykaa. Actually, this is the matte compact powder. It is not supposed to be a bronzer, but I choose the shade 08. Now I really have been loving this as a bronzer so much. This is amazing as a bronzer. The formulation of this powder is actually really good, and I actually want Nykaa to come out with real bronzers that have a lot of different skin tones and that has a lot of different undertones. This is a very neutral type of a bronzer on my skin shade. It's like skin tone actually, but I really love it because I don't know why, but this just blends into the skin so well. I don't tend to like much of powder products, I do have to say. If you guys know me, you would know that I always use cream products, cream bronzer, cream highlighter, cream blush. But for the bronzer, I did choose the Nykaa one, and that says a lot about this product because I honestly really love it. Like, it looks so natural. I look like I'm naturally bronzed. That's why I really love it a lot. So the for blush, this was the hardest choice I had to make because there are a couple of different formulation blush that I like. I do like a powder blush sometimes. I do like a cream blush that's in a pot, and I do like a liquid blush like this. So it actually depends on my mood. You know, blush depends on my mood and depends on the look that I'm going for, like what I want. But if I had to choose one blush, I would choose the Hina Henna Beauty Lush Rogue. Now, why I would choose this is because of the formulation. The other blushes that I have in my collection, I love everything, you know, equally. But I am choosing this because of its formulation. The formulation is very unique and it reflects on the price. I know that a lot of people can say, oh my God, that's a little, you know, expensive, because I do affordable makeup on this channel. But I have not tried a blush like this ever. This blush, I would say the formulation is so good. You can blend this with your fingers, you can blend this with a sponge, you can blend this with a brush, and it's still going to give you a very natural look. It's just going to blend by itself, you know. This is a type of makeup that would work with your skin to make it look natural. And I have to say that if I am using a hydrating base, like a hydrating foundation, hydrating, you know, primer, then my base is hydrating, so this would look hydrating on the skin. But if I'm using a matte foundation, a matte primer, I'm setting my face, this one actually would look matte. So this depends on what type of base you are putting on your face, and that is how this would work. So that is why I chose this, because this is a very versatile product. I feel like this actually would work with all different skin types. Even if you have oily skin and you have never used a liquid blush, this is your, you know, choice. This is an amazing blush, and I feel like a lot of people who are into cream blushes, you are going to love this. And I honestly should definitely get two more different shades of this, but I love the shade so much. This is the shade Rosette. Now, moving on to highlighter, I actually did not choose a highlighter because I honestly don't use highlighter that much these days, so I did not choose one. So the next product I have to talk about is obviously eyes, and as boring as I am, like I'm really basic, I had to choose a basic palette. Now, this is not basic. The formulation, this is not a basic eyeshadow palette. That's because the mattes in here are beautiful. It is blendable, it is creamy, it is pigmented. It's going to work, you know. Even if you are a beginner, even if you don't know that much of blending, this eyeshadow palette is going to work. And another thing why I chose this eyeshadow palette is because I really love the shimmers on this palette. There is not a single palette in my collection that I love both matte and shimmer in the same palette except this one. I really love the shimmers. Actually, all the shimmers on this one I really really love, and that is why I chose this. If you guys know, I'm not a shimmer person. Right now I'm getting a little bit into shimmers, but not that much. But that is why if I had to pick only one palette for the rest of my life, this is going to be the one. The formulation is just wow. I know that this is not a, you know, big brand kind of a palette. This I don't know, this is just a random palette that I got from Amazon, but this has been working so well, and yeah, I really do like it. One of my favorite palettes, to be honest. So next comes mascara. So for mascara, I'm going in with the Mars mascara. Now, I love this formulation a lot. I'm not a mascara kind of a girl because I always do apply false lashes, and a lot of the times I'll just apply a mascara that, you know, that's just okay. But after getting the Mars one, I have been continuously non-stop applying this, and I really love how this makes my lashes look. It just gives in the volume, it gives a little bit of length also, but it doesn't, you know, like, it doesn't crumble, it doesn't look like spider legs. You know, a lot of mascaras tend to do that, but yeah, I really do like this. This is a very good, decent mascara, and for the price, I just feel like, yes, this is the one that I'm going to keep. So now coming on to the lips, if I had to keep only one lip liner, obviously it's going to be a brown lip liner. So this is the Miss Claire lip liner, and this is in the shade coffee brown. I really love this lip liner. I'm choosing this, like, you know, over Wet n Wild because I think the formulation of this lip liner is better than the Wet n Wild. The Wet n Wild is also good, don't get me wrong, but I like this more, so that's why I'm choosing this, and I like the shade also. So for the lipstick, I'm actually choosing this Lakme lipstick, and it's in the shade nude, soft nude. I'm choosing this lipstick because it is this peach nude, and I'm someone, peach nude always works for me. Like, it doesn't matter if I'm applying makeup or no makeup, if I am doing a really like a black smoky eye, peach brown toned lipstick always works. And on my skin tone, I really love this lipstick a lot, and not only that, the formulation is also very, very good on this lipstick. So I just had to go with this. You know, while choosing the lipstick and the blush, I had to think, you know, I had a lot of options, and I was just like, you know, choosing all different types of formulations. I was going through all different, you know, all through my collection, and I just had to come up with something that I absolutely love, and this is just the lipstick for me. So that was it for today's video. I hope you guys liked it. This video is like a 30-minute long video. I mean, I have been sitting here filming this video for 2 hours now, and yeah, this, thank you so much for watching. I hope this video was helpful, or, you know, it was just fun to make, because if ever in life I just had to keep 10 makeup products, I would definitely choose all these. So anyway, thank you so much for watching, and I love you guys a lot, and I will see you in my next video. Also, if you are someone who hasn't subscribed to my channel yet, you can hit the subscribe button if you like the vibe here, and also the notification bell. And yeah, I'll see you guys in the next one. Bye bye.